Welcome to our last video in our Lecture 6 for Applied Statistics and Probability for Engineers. The last type of plot or graph we're going to talk about is a probability plot. And this is a little bit different than the ones that we've talked about before in this chapter, mostly because this time we have to do some converting to the data before we plot it. This one now deals mostly with probability distribution. So how do we know if a particular probability distribution is a reasonable model for a data set? So we use something called a probability plot to help us verify such an assumption using a subjective visual examination. So a histogram of a large data set reveals the shape of a distribution. The histogram of a small data set, however, would not provide such a clear picture. A probability plot then is helpful for all data set sizes. So we've talked in previous videos about which graphical analysis methods are better for large data sets and small data sets. Probability plots then are versatile in that you can use them for any size of data set. Okay, so the way we create a probability plot is, first of all, we sort the data observations in ascending order, so the smallest number to the biggest number. So then we put the observed value, I sub j, plotted against the cumulative distribution, and this then is how we would come up with the cumulative distribution. So each value j minus 0.5 divided by n, where n is the amount of values I have, and j then is just like its placeholder. So if it's value number 1, j is 1. Value number 2, j is 2. So the paired numbers then, so my x and my new cumulative distribution, which would be my y, are plotted on the probability paper or plot of the proposed distribution. So if they form a straight line, then it's reasonable to assume that the data follows the proposed distribution. So like if we think it's going to be a normal distribution, and if there's a straight line that goes through it, then yes, it is a normal distribution. And we will cover this a lot more in the next few chapters, so I don't love that we're kind of skimming the surface with it now, but at least this is an introduction to it. So let's look at this example. This is in your book, but the effective service life in minutes of batteries used in a laptop are given in the following table. We hypothesize that the battery life is adequately modeled by a normal distribution. The probability plot is shown on the normal probability vertical scale. Okay, so once again, I'm going to take all these values and I'm going to reorder them in order of smallest to biggest. Then over here I'm going to create a column that's called J, where J is just numbering them, 1 through 10. Then over here I'm going to put them in this function, J minus 0.5 divided by 10, because there's 10 total. And I'm going to run these values in that formula and I get this. So if you notice, this right here then is my cumulative distribution. So this right here is the probability of that value, okay, the cumulative probability of that value. So these values or these probabilities are each of these little scatter points right here, okay? So this y-axis right here is my cumulative distribution, or this formula that I just did times 100, okay? So I plot those and I try and fit them with a best fit line, a linear best fit line, and it's pretty straight. It's a pretty linear plot. So then I would say that a normal probability is adequate to describe this distribution. So these then are the exact same values. All we're going to do now is we're going to standardize them. So we're going to still have this J column. We still order these in order from smallest to biggest. We still have this cumulative distribution formula over here where I still do that and get the same values. The difference then now is that I'm going to find the Z value for each of these values right here, okay? So obviously in order to find a z value, I would have had to have been told or be able to figure out a standard deviation and a mean, right? So I find the z value for each of those, and then I graph the z values. So I personally like to plot these x values against their standardized values, because to me that makes more sense to be able to visualize a standard normal distribution plotted like this. But you can plot it against the cumulative distribution if you want to, whatever you prefer, whatever makes sense to you. The probability plot can identify variations from a normal distribution. So we can tell if something is a normal curve, which is this plot right here. Normal just means that beautiful bell shape, right? And it's symmetrical on both sides. It can let us know if we have a light tail distribution, and a light tail distribution then means that my tails are thin. So if we look right here, So this dotted line right here is my normal distribution so that we can compare, okay? So that means that I have lesser values in the tails, okay? So I have fewer scores in the tails. A heavy tail distribution then would look like this, where I have tons of values in the tails, meaning the tails are thick. So you can then compare each of these to their normal distribution. These distributions can then also help us identify if something is skewed or not. So we've been using the term skewed a lot, and I don't know if we've ever actually defined it. Skewed just means that something isn't symmetrical, okay? So if you look at this, this is called a positively skewed distribution, and that means then that the tail is more going to the right than otherwise, okay? So it's not symmetrical and it has a longer tail to the right, so the data is skewed to the right. Okay, so the same thing over here, the tail is to the left, would be a negatively skewed distribution. And that makes sense, right? So I have a longer tail over here in the negative direction than otherwise. So these probability plots can help us visualize this just in the graphing of the plots. Okay, so if we look at these, this is kind of visualizing what those plots look like. So right here, A is where we have a light tail distribution. And we can see that then because the data are kind of squeezed together, okay? A heavy tail distribution then would be this in the middle right here, where these values are kind of stretched out, okay? Versus up here, squeezed together, kind of going more vertical. Over here then, if I have a right skewed distribution, that means that one end of it is squeezed and one is stretched. So one kind of comes in like this and one is stretched out this way. So that's it for probability plot distributions. Just remember our goal. Our goal is to be able to find data points similar to this example along a linearly sloped line from beginning to end. So see how all these points are clustered around a linearly sloped line? That's the goal, not to have these endpoints somewhere else like stretched or squeezed, how we just talked about, but to have them all close around this line. Okay, so that's it for this chapter on graphical analysis. So here's a bunch of new words that we've talked about. Just make sure to run through it and make sure that you're familiar with each type of display technique, as well as graphing it, as well as the numerical methods or analyses we talked about in the beginning.